tune book exactly what happened when the council decided to bypass the public and announced the day before the bollards arrived. Don't mention the bollards. The West Derby Road turned into the West Derby Road congestion scheme. And the pavements still haven't recovered. But can I say, we have seen some progress. We have seen the trial out of the underground bins. We have got one set of underground bins, and we actually had to put the foot down and say to our council, yes, we're going to consultation in Tubrook. We'll expect Tubrook residents to go to Kensington to look at the bins for their street layout, and then it serves it particularly way under the local consultation. And I believe that has been incredibly successful. The recycling rate, the sealed bill of Staple Avenue has gone from 15% of the refuse being recycled to 30%. Actually, that is one of the lesser achievements, because in areas where recycling rates are at a much lower starting point, in some of the wards, including Anfield, at 3%, the benefit has even been more profound. So, but it begs the question, that was trialled. We were promised an evaluation by, I've lost count of the chief detective we had recently. I think two chief detectives ago. We were promised, it's a bit like counting in the mind. Two chief detectives ago, we were promised an evaluation on the success of the underground bin scheme, because we believe we've actually suggested four sites where the land's available, where the natural geographical area could actually create a reduction of the service rounds. And it's just been in limbo. So I would say to the colleagues, great, there are some really good trials done. The idea of a trial is to try it, find out it works, and then implement it. And we're still waiting.
Thank you, Councillor Bryan.
Thank you, Deputy Lord Mayor. I want to speak on this because, as many people know, I've pointed out, I was a school teacher for many years. But the other thing I also engaged in for at least 8 years was social research. And I'm very much in favour of bringing the public in as much as we can on this issue, because I'm afraid there's a lot of ignorance. And when you get ignorance, you get lack of cooperation. And even if this is going to extend the period before we get any decent action, I would say that by having a jury of citizens, we are going to get better action, we're going to get better cooperation, and we're going to get people wanting things to happen, instead of endlessly criticising every little thing that goes wrong. And I'd just like to cite one brief example in my own ward. Fortunately, we're going to have a major investment from the Housing Association, who's got the most houses up there. But already, they are telling me that when they knock on the houses of their tenants, that they're being refused entry for retrofitting. Wouldn't you think that people would welcome with open arms investment, retrofitting, not having to pay for it themselves? Well, I think this is a process by which we need to get people's active cooperation. And I've always realised that although we need some top-down initiatives, if you
East Luton project, Dave and Teddy, we've got an industry-leading partnership with Merseyside Police and how that's managed, and people have lost their driving licences, using them inappropriately. I could bore you with all of those things. I could tell you about how we've cut bus fares for kids over the past decade, and it's doubled the number of young people on buses. There's all those different things I could say, but the most important thing is that, one, we practice what we preach, but actually, as Trish has said, we're bringing the public on with us on this. Because if we don't, quite frankly, if we don't sort of face this as how we empower people to address climate emergency, and retrofit and insulation is absolutely spot on to this, how we address the climate emergency, the cost of living crisis at the end of the day, fuel poverty, people's health and quality of the homes that they're in. If we don't do that, if we don't bring people along with us, quite frankly, there's a huge risk that climate emergency could become the next Brexit. And that would make it a million times worse. So actually, by engaging with the people of the city, doing a jury process, and we want to do a jury process because we think that would be the deepest down of doing it, I know we'll be able to get the people of the city to give us the right guidance, the choices and compromises that we need to make. Trust the people of the city. Let's crack on.
Thank you. We now go to the votes on the First Amendment moved by Councillor Crowe. Can I see those in favour of the amendment? Can I see those against? That is clearly lost. Can I see those in favour of the Second Amendment moved by Councillor Lincolnson? And those against, that is clearly lost. Can I see a vote on the motion as unamended? Can I see those against? So that is carried with non-dissenting. Okay, let's move to the opposition leader's motion. This is a motion of 20 minutes duration. Can I just point out that no one was more surprised than I am to see that I was going to be second in this. That was a mistake. Even before I was elevated to this spot, it serves you right. You have to turn up at group meetings to make sure you don't get jobs to do, doesn't it? We're going to start off with the leader of the opposition opening your way.
Especially my old man.
Some of our fantastic volunteers and groups go out and clear our streets day in, day out, week in, week out. And I'm struck by just how much they actually do. And I find myself thinking, if these people weren't there, what would we do and what would our streets actually look like? And I wanted to pay particular tribute to those people. And I know there's some councillors in this chamber tonight that join them. I want to pay tribute to those councillors also. But what I want this council to say is we're with you, and we're going to do what a local authority should do is to say that we don't have important issues managing the public realm in areas of the city. Any engaged ward councillor will know where the hotspots are in their wards, and those ward councillors have an active role to play in sorting them out. There are so many examples we can point to where innovative and effective solutions are being deployed, but none of these have made it onto the face of the motion, because all it seems that the opposition wants to do is talk the city down, so much, quote, for upbeat and positive. So let me list a few. The success of underground bins, 100 tonnes of waste removed in Operation Bango, 10 prosecutions of graffiti banned was in Operation Doodle. The political decision consistent with our values of exploring the return of all of our street services back into local authority control, and of course the pending rollout of the neighbourhood model, investing in frontline services across every community in this city. None of that on the front of any focus leaflet, nor any introspection on what happened in 2010 to get local authorities into this quandary. There's lots in the motion they get right. You're right to celebrate volunteers, and you're right, we're with you. We couldn't do it without them. You're right to lobby the government for increased powers. We need them to determine bad actors in the city. We've kept all those ideas in the amendments, and I genuinely thank all those Lib Dem councillors, Councillor Klein was mentioned specifically, who worked to keep their patch clean. It's just a shame that they should undermine their only motion tonight by talking the city down and omitting all the innovative work done not just by people in here, but by the many, many officers and LSSL staff in the city to keep Liverpool clean in very challenging times.
Can I just respond to one part of the debate? I know we keep on hearing about the neighbourhood model rolling out, but when's he going to leave the starting gate? We've been discussing it quite a long time. Can I also say, we've heard about the success of the underground bins, whether they're going to be rolled out. I went down to Newton Road to look, to discuss with our officers about that rollout, and I saw there were a whole plethora of communal bins that were about to go out. And I said, where are they going and when? We haven't discussed the councils yet. So there was a lot of things to be done. There's a lot of things waiting in the backyard. Can I speak to the amendments? Because I think I would hope both parties would support it. When I chaired the committee to the panel, we had a ruling from the government which councillors of all parties all over England and Wales objected to, and that was the removal of the right for local councils to use CCTV to catch environmental crime. It meant that there was that more legal hurdles to go through to put a camera on CCTV on hotspots. And we've all got hotspots in our wards. That created expense and bureaucracy and prevented us doing it. And I'm asking for a simple, easy way to make prosecutions easier by catching the people, and that is we should restore our right to CCTV on hot environmental hotspots. Because the government's written legislation put more hurdles in doing so. We all agreed it when the change was done, and I would still call that change to be reversed. Thank you, my Lord Mayor.
Thank you, Deputy Lord Mayor. I'm old enough to remember, I'm sure many of you do, the Britain Tidy campaign. I'm not sure now, it was a long time ago, I'm not sure how effective that was. But
it. I litterpick Sam Street. I also litterpick in on Walton Vale, which is in Sam's ward, and happy to do it through the Oral Park Green Team. All the time we see litter everywhere. Yes, part of it has got to be education. One of the things I did as a ward rep council before the reorganisation was to spend a term going into two local primary schools doing creative writing with kids about litter. Now this sort of stuff has to be done, but we've also got to say there is a minority of committed flighters. LSSL generally does a very good job, despite the cuts that we've all talked about that Liam referenced earlier. Give you one example. I reported huge boxes full of commercial waste that were dumped on Warbeck Avenue Bridge. I reported it once on the online, and then because it hadn't been moved, I reported it to our neighbourhood officer. Two teams went out fighting to pick it up, one beat the other one by about half an hour. That's brilliant. That's absolutely fantastic. But then come the problem, the problems that we need on enforcement. And that's why I'm tending to vote for the Lib Dem motion, because we need to say how much we're going to fine people. When I see in a couple of alleyways in my ward, people repeatedly piling up black bin bags because they've got insufficient communal bins, but there is also a small minority who are actually misusing the whole system. We clear 40 bin bags and literally the next day there are 40 more. That's not normal. That is some sort of commercial dumping by some of the shops that back onto this alley. They need enforcement, and they need it to be hard, and they need it to hurt. And that's why I believe we've got to have an amount of money that stings them. The other one, which is related to litter, is you see some of the most appalling behaviour when it comes to dog poop bags. Who throws a dog poop bag into the road so it gets run over, and then we have to actually shovel it up in the green team? Who puts them lined up like little ducks on the alleyway back wall so they end up falling? I'm not kidding with this stuff. We had to do enforcement on one house where there was literally 40 odd piles of poop. And the kid next door couldn't go out in July to play because of this irresponsible person. And we had to do enforcement on that. So, oddly, for somebody who's a libertarian socialist and generally wants to educate, 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 which I did all my career, I actually want to metaphorically slap their backsides with a big guy that we slap on. How's that news?
So our last two speakers are Councillor St Aldra and Councillor Mumby, and I'm going to confine the debate to 2 minutes each, as we are well over the time on the Stand Award. So it's 2 minutes each.
Thank you, Deputy Lord Mayor. I'd like to counter some of the arguments that say that we that so the Dems don't give enough credit to the staff. First of all, I give credit to the street team officers who are having a stressful time during the transition to the neighbourhood model. Street team isn't perfect by any means, but you know, the staff are often on the work in terms of the case work they're expected to do. It's too early to say yet whether the situation is actually going to improve. I mean, beginning the process of the cluster, neighbourhood cluster arrangements. Well, we'll have to see how it goes. Now the city centre and the tourist spots do get good treatments and have an effective cleanup system in place, which is all very well and good for our international image as a city. Yet, you go out to the outskirts of the city, to those terrace provinces, of which we all know them in our wards, it's a completely different picture. Street litter, dump fouling, dumping in the alleyways, unbin refuse bags, mattresses, overflowing bins, overgrown shrubbery, potholes, sunken drains, and worst of all, rat infestation. Rat infestation is by far the commonest complaint I get by the residents in Weathertree Village, and it's turning into a plague. It's a real health hazard. I expect it's quite similar across the city for other areas where you have elected members who get the blame. Quite unfairly, in my opinion,
Councillor.
Yeah. So if I can just sum up my Lord, then I'm getting on there.
My Lord is fine.
Coming back, drop the fans off at the bus stop there, and the coach driver them take all the litter off. So that night we get a whole load of bin bags. We've been trying for months to get a bin put there, the big euro bins, and we haven't managed it yet. That is about the council system not working. We are not talking the city down. If we're talking anybody down here, we're talking down the Labour Party. And you've got to acknowledge this is problem and you've got to fix it. Because otherwise we're serious.
Seems to be not that obvious.